You know, for me at this stage right now, it's still a little hard for me to be happy.
And the Dallas Mavericks are going to the NBA Finals.
Being right there, and it's just ripped away from you all in an instant.
I think there are a lot of players that have to retire without an NBA title.
It's going to hurt for Dirk for a while, but he's still our guy.
We only got to that stage one time. I just want to get another chance.
This is the most complete Dirk Nowitzki that we've seen.
Sometimes he's not even human.
Every time you face something in your life, you have to fight.
There's no way we're going out like this.
If I'm Dirk Nowitzki, I'm thinking, this is my last shot.
The ninth pick in the 1998 NBA draft, Dirk Nowitzki from Würzburg, Germany.
I didn't know what to expect, obviously, back in the days when I got there. You know, everything was hard. When Mark Cuban bought the team, we kind of became close friends, and he became a mentor and a supporter of mine, and he always had my back on and off the court.
Here is Nowitzki. That one's going to be short.
Dirk's been quiet for a while.
I struggled Major League in my first year. I never really got adjusted to the place. Looking back at it, it was a very important year for me. I learned a lot.
Every time I see him play, he's better than his numbers on the stat sheet.
I always try to keep my ears and eyes open. How do the veterans, how do they warm up? How do they do a pregame? How do they do interviews? Definitely, I came in at the right time where the league was changing. They changed the rule, they put in the zone. Everything opened up more. There was more freedom of movement. That was perfect for me, you know, spread the floor.
Here's Nowitzki. Dirk Nowitzki's got it stuck on automatic.
Back then, I had a coach named Don Nelson. His system was great for me. You know, he wanted me to shoot. He wanted me to spread the floor. So I got lucky with a great coach and a great system.
Nowitzki, the rookie, knocks it down. And you're going to like watching Dirk Nowitzki.
The last 10 games in the first year, we were out of the playoffs, and Nelly gave him a chance. He's like, you know what? The pressure's gone. Just get some experience under your belt and have fun with it. That's the confidence I needed. You know, it showed me you can perform in this league when you work hard, and things got a lot better.
Here's Nowitzki driving on Pippen. Yep, and a foul.
Hey, that's against a pretty darn good defender right there. That's Scottie Pippen on defense.
I had some great teammates. I always thank Steve Nash and Michael Finley to kind of help get my career going. They were really supportive when I was going through tough times early in my career.
And Dirk's a lifelong friend. You know, we came to Dallas the same day he was drafted. I was traded. Both of us young and green, and him in particular, because he came from a small town in Germany all the way to the NBA. I luckily had 2 years in the league and was kind of able to help show him the ropes, and not only about the league, but American culture and life. We lived in the same apartment complex.
On the road, he would take me out of the hotel so I don't be in the hotel the whole time and be homesick. So he was very important the first couple years.
The biggest thing we had in common, period, was that we both were obsessed with the game. We'd go to the gym twice a day in the off season, and after practice, we'd go back at night and play one-on-one and horse and challenge ourselves to get better. At that stage, we were very borderline NBA players. I think a lot of people thought our careers would probably fizzle out, but we pushed and pushed and pushed, and we pushed each other.
Nash setting up Nowitzki again, and he's on a run.
You know, we took that franchise, you know, with Michael Finley, from being the worst team in the league to making the conference finals in a 6-year span.
When we first made the All-Star game together, that was a very special time. That was a great feeling of, hey, we made it together.
We had some amazing times together. Great, great friend, and an incredible basketball player. So I feel really lucky to call him a friend and a teammate.
To see him go, that was tough, obviously. He was a big part of our franchise. The city here loved him. You just have to move on. That's how life is, and I think we both adjusted to life without each other on the court.
The Atlanta Hawks select Jason Terry from the University of Arizona.
Getting drafted, realizing that I finally made it to my ultimate goal, it was phenomenal. In 2004, I was traded from Atlanta to the Dallas Mavericks. That was a big moment for me.
Terry sucks it down. Oh, Jet, fly away for the dunk and the foul.
Myself, Dirk Nowitzki, when you've been through a battle with a guy for as many years as I had, We've been through so many playoff wars. You know, I can go back to our first playoff experience together against Houston in 2005.
Well, Jason Terry is the man of the hour.
We were down 0-2. We come back. We beat them. We go to the next round. We lose to Phoenix by a last-second shot by Steve Nash.
The MVP, Steve Nash, does it again.
That was a dark time for us in our relationship. In 2006, the next year we come back.
We had an amazing run. We never beat the Spurs before in the playoffs. Just to make it to that stage, game 7 on the road.
Ginobili for 3, yes! San Antonio leads for the 5-5-1. Timeout, Dallas.
When Manu made that 3, that was the loudest I ever heard a gym. You know, they haven't led that whole game. That huddle, I've never heard anything like it. You know, I could barely hear Avery say anything. You know, all I saw was he drawing up the play. In game 6, we had a similar situation at home. We were down 3, and it was like 20 seconds to go. And I forced the 3 out of the corner.
Dirk all over the corner for 3. It's an air ball.
I didn't make it, and we lost the game. A lot of coaches talked to me, and I thought to myself, if I'm ever in this situation again, there's that much time left. Try to go to the basket, try to make something happen.
Nowitzki goes right at Bowen, and the foul! So Nowitzki to the line with a chance to tie the game.
I knew once I caught the ball, Bruce was up on me. I was able to get to the basket and got fouled, obviously one of my biggest plays in my career, and it helped us win the game in overtime, which was unbelievable.
And how about Dallas? They will take the series in 7 and head to the Western Conference Final to face the Suns. Dirk and Steve, close friends as members of the Mavericks.
They miss each other, but Dirk and Nash both have gotten better with their respective teams.
Out to Dirk, right side angle, 3, yes sir! Dallas in front as Dirk drills the triple. Backing in low right, Dirk spinning baseline, and to the hole with authority, he dunks it!
Boy, what a strong move by Dirk Nowitzki.
Nowitzki for 3, yes! 50 points for Dirk Nowitzki.
It's been some kind of show.
The Mavericks headed to the NBA Finals for the first time in the history of the franchise.
NBA Finals game 1, and this building is ready.
We get to the finals, being right there, trying to realize your dream right there in front of you. It just motivates you.
Terry to the basket. Oh, a strong finish from Jason Terry.
That point guard position is going to be big throughout this series.
Wade to the basket. Wade with a strong finish. Nowitzki fires away. Puts it in at the buzzer. The Dallas Mavericks take game 1 of the NBA Finals. Harry right back with the steal and puts it in.
Big pass.
Stackhouse, a long 3. Does it again. And a foul. Stackhouse for 3. Bang! Gary Stackhouse on the shot clock expires. But the Dallas Mavericks with a convincing victory once again.
We're up 2-0. We felt good about ourselves going to Miami.
I can still hear Rick Ross from the introduction music that they will play. Like, I still hear that.
Nowitzki for 3. Dirk Nowitzki from downtown. And the Mavericks with their largest lead of the game. Looking for Wade.
Yeah, they're bringing him off the baseline screen.
Wade on the drive. Inside. Banks it in.
What a move. Great hang time.
And there's 1 second remaining. That's plenty of time to catch and shoot.
Big time pressure on Dirk Nowitzki.
Knocked away, and the Heat survive. A stirring fourth quarter comeback. And the Miami Heat right back in the finals. Wade. Banks it in as the buzzer sounds.
Howard and Nowitzki have got to get going in this game.
Wade for 3.
Wow.
And the cheers begin. The NBA Finals are tied at 2 games apiece.
Game 5. The series was 2-2.
Wade looking. Pulls up. Banks it in. Tie game with 2.8 remaining. Timeout Dallas.
I had a chance to win the game in regulation.
Terry puts it up for the win.
And I missed.
No good. Overtime.
Right then I was like, oh, man.
Overtime in game 5 of the NBA Finals. Nowitzki on the drive, falling away. It's good. Dirk Nowitzki gives the Mavericks a 1-point lead. 9.1 seconds remain.
Dallas cannot fall asleep.
Wade on the drive, double team. Wade looking for an opening. He's fouled. Shot won't go, but he will shoot two with 1.9 remaining.
Now that was an incredible situation.
They call the foul on Nowitzki, and it didn't look like. Heat lead.
Now you got to watch now, because if they make a catch over half court, they'll get a decent shot.
Just get it in. Harris puts it up for the win. Oh, no good. And Miami wins again to take a 3-2 lead. Another thriller. Mark Cuban, furious.
We had two more games left in the series, and we were going back home for those two games. We had a realistic shot. We got off to a great start in game 6.
To Nowitzki! Nice passing inside, and Morning with the finish. Haslam, pretty dish. Nowitzki very aggressive early. Drive for the hole! That's Nowitzki! Backdoor blocked by Morning.
Great block.
Nice pass to Haslam. Blocked by Stackhouse. The Dallas Mavericks hoping to force a game 7. They do not want the Heat celebrating on their home floor. Here comes Williams. Fancy pass to Morning. And Morning right at Benga. Desperation time for the Mavericks. Now facing elimination. Down by 3.
And then there at the end, I had another shot to tie the game up.
3-point game. Dallas out of timeouts. Terry puts it up. Won't go. Rebound Wade. The Miami Heat, they've done it. They win their first championship in franchise history.
Ref didn't call a foul. I always kid Gary Payton now, man, you stole my ring.
You could see that there was a foul before he took that shot.
I mean, it was a tough pill to swallow.
Well, I think it was the most disappointing loss of my career, of my life. And be up 2-0 and have everything going our way, and then it's basically ripping your heart out and not come up with the goal. It was devastating, and it took me a long time to get over it.
It was dark. You would have thought the lights were off. I just remember sharing a moment with Daryl Armstrong as the confetti was coming down, hitting us in the head, and Miami's walking off, they're celebrating, we're walking out. I was disappointed for sure, but then seeing a guy like himself who had poured so much into our team, I could just see the tears flowing from his eyes because he was in probably, I think he was in his 15th or 16th season, and he was like, man, I don't have any more opportunities.
For me, I just had to get away, you know, not think about it for that summer. So we went away a little bit and traveled the world a little bit, just see something, do something else.
I will tell you this, it made me the man I am today because when you go through an adversity like that, it could either break you down and destroy your confidence, or it can motivate you and propel you to greatness.
I think looking back at it now, I think the experience kind of helped me. I think in a way it made me stronger. It made me want to finish more in fourth quarters, be better. Just made me more hungry and motivated me to keep plugging and keep fighting.
That next season, obviously, we were on a mission. I was playing at a high level. Dirk had an MVP-type season.
Dirk got another feathery, soft, silky, smooth touch by Nowitzki.
We had a great regular season, won 67 games. We won 67 games.
Our record was incredible. We actually started out 0-4 that season, and we were just like, forget it. We're going to play our best 7 players, and let's ride.
He'll go to Dirk.
Jump shot over Barry. 1.3 to go.
Dirk Nowitzki, I'll tell you, he's got big what's in him.
We went on a tremendous run. I think we had three win streaks of 12-plus games.
Ducks it home. Oh, my goodness.
We're rolling through the regular season. We had high expectations coming off the finals the year before, and we thought this was our year.
The NBA playoffs, top seed, the Dallas Mavericks with the best record in the league against Golden State, seeded 8.
We ran into a team, the Golden State Warriors, with a great coach.
Don Nelson. Head coach of the Mavericks for 8 years, leaving under less than friendly conditions. Mark Cuban and Don Nelson, they are not friends anymore.
I may not get along well with Nelly the person, but Nelly the coach I have unlimited respect for. He's a phenomenal coach, and he proved it year in and year out.
But they had guys like Steven Jackson, Baron Davis, Jason Richardson, Matt Barnes. They had guys that can defend. They made it extremely tough on us.
We met a hot team. They were shooting the ball extremely well from everywhere.
Oh, Davis!
And when I said Steven Jackson doesn't care, I mean it in the best possible way. He doesn't care about missing.
We just didn't play our best. We missed a lot of shots, missed a lot of easy shots.
We weren't nearly the team we were the year before. And we just ran out of gas, and we just couldn't beat them.
Middle bounce pass to Richardson, jammed it! Right-hand slam!
That might be the exclamation point.
96-75, Richardson steals the ball on a pass. Throws to Barnes. Barnes down the middle, pass to Jay Rich. Three ball left side, got it!
Take a fork in them, they're done.
Golden State really took it to us, had a great series, and bounced us in the first round.
The Golden State Warriors have pulled off the greatest upset in the history of the NBA playoffs.
That was another really tough loss, almost as tough as losing the finals.
I feel bad for them. I feel bad for all the guys. I mean, they played their hearts out all season. I know the character of our players, and, you know, it was an unfortunate matchup. Didn't turn out the way we won, but now it's last season, and we move on.
It is my great pleasure to present the 2006-2007 NBA Most Valuable Player Award to Dirk Nowitzki. Come on up here, Dirk.
I got the MVP that year, which really didn't even feel right because we're already out of the playoffs. Obviously, a lot of things go through your mind because of the way the season ended and with the postseason. But, you know, this is an award for the regular season. So I try to look at it that way and be positive. And I've always been about the team. You spend so much time on the road and in buses and hotels and watching film. And I'll always, you know, cherish the moments I have with my teammates. So, all around, really overwhelmed. Great day, and I'm trying to enjoy it as much as I can. Thanks. That's a year I will always remember, and my MVP season always combined with a first-round exit.
Dirk really, really took that season hard, and he had a lot of self-reflecting to do.
I had to get away for a couple weeks afterwards.
He went on his journey to Australia and camped out in the wilderness. When he came back, man, he had a fire in his eyes. He had grown his hair out, and he really was on a mission the next 3 years to figure it out.
And then never really made it past the second round.
Nowitzki, no, and the Hornets take this series.
Had a couple first rounds exit, made it to the second round ones.
Backing down, no place to go, fading, short. Denver's headed to the Western Conference Finals.
You make mistakes as a player and as a competitor, and you have to learn from that. You have to go forward.
We didn't win it the next years.
And that is it, and the San Antonio Spurs, wow, the seventh seed on top of the two.
The greatest power to me is the power of belief from within.
You know, I always try to keep improving, you know. I think that's a major thing. I was never trying to be satisfied. So I just always try to learn and work hard in the summers, play national team always helped me get better. I always see myself as a student of the game and trying to get better and add new stuff every summer.
If you're all of 7 feet and you can shoot a one-legged step back and make
off
it,
balance.
You cannot be guarded if you can make that shot.
to figure out, like, I got to be better. My teammates have to be better. He challenged us, each guy individually. He challenged management to go out and get a Jason Kidd, to go out and get Tyson Chandler, to go get Sean Marion.
Me and Dirk played together 5 years in Dallas, and he's a great teammate, and he just want to win. He works very hard. He don't say much, but when he do say something, he's really adamant and passionate about it. So, like, when he speak up, you gotta know he's off or something like that.
I was trying to learn to be a leader, and during the game, if I see something, or during practice, I see something I don't like, then I speak up. So for me, it was like a learning curve.
Nowitzki drives and finish.
He's a big, humble guy. It was fun because of the teammates we had, though. Everybody, we had an unselfish team, and that made the game a lot easier for us.
When you have guys that have been there, veteran guys that have experienced and witnessed failure, and have been the man on their team where the team was counting on them and they didn't deliver, but now you've assembled this group together. You know, by that year, 2011, we have finally assembled a team that had a realistic shot of winning the championship.
Jet got the tattoo in preseason.
We had a team gathering, and it was like, man, I'm putting that Larry O'Brien trophy because I know and I believe we got the team to do it.
We had such high expectations when the season started. Everybody held each other accountable for everything throughout that whole year. We just wanted to make sure we got to the playoffs healthy. We just felt like it's going to be our year.
You have to make things happen, and that's how I always approach things. Nothing will be given to you. You got to go out and take it and fight for it.
Nowitzki again, 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Terry the three, right on time. And Dallas is going to take this first round series against Portland.
Everything that we poured into it, I mean, all of us had moments through that playoff run. Page Stojakovic, if you go look back at what he did in that series, I mean, he probably shot 70% from three.
Stojakovic, another one!
It was phenomenal, the shooting.
Stojakovic again. He's 6-4-6 shooting threes.
He was so instrumental in how we disassembled the Lakers in the fashion we did. I mean, you swept the two-time defending champions.
For the fourth time in franchise history, the Dallas Mavericks are going to the Western Conference Finals. There will be a new champion in the NBA.
So close in 06, and that was a devastating loss. You know, I just want to get another chance at the big shot.
I didn't expect us to make it to the finals the year we made it to the finals. You just got to get on a roll and, you know, be playing well and have the right matchups. I mean, I think we're as good as any team in the league. Now we just got to go out and prove it.
Their team with a chance to eliminate the Thunder. Nowitzki, reverse layup. Puts it in. What a shot from Dirk Nowitzki. Westbrook inside, stolen.
The Mavericks showing this is a different Dallas team. Poise, grit, toughness, defense.
Durant nails a three-pointer. The Thunder just won't go away. And Nowitzki taking away their will sometimes. Nowitzki, it's good. Oh, 46 points.
If I'm Serge Ibaka, I'm naming my first son Dirk. This has been unbelievable.
You know, you talk about the Western Conference Finals, and then you watch Dirk. He literally put us on his back and was like, look, we're not going to be denied. We're getting back to the finals.
Nowitzki again for the lead. Bang!
And the Dallas Mavericks, and for the second time in franchise history, will play for the NBA championship. And Dirk Nowitzki, who said all he plays for now is to get back to the NBA Finals and play for a title and get his chance.
It took us 5 years to just get back to the stage. I think we would have played anybody in the finals. I guess it was kind of destiny that it was Miami again.
You're facing the exact same team. You know, not the same team as far as players.
The answer to the question everybody wants to know. LeBron, what's your decision?
In this fall, I'm going to take my talents to South Beach and join the Miami Heat.
There was no words to be said. We knew what time it was. You already knew what it meant for us to be back in that building. The ball boys, the managers, they had their big shiny rings on. So there was no other motivation needed. There was no speeches, there was nothing. There was just us in them uniforms, and we knew what we had to do to get the job done.
Game one, NBA Finals, baby. Can y'all say more?
Let's play hard, our pace, our tempo, go, go, our tempo. Go.
Nowitzki. Oh, there he goes. He's hit some incredible shots during this playoff run. Moving to his right. Will he get it off in time? He does.
LeBron James hit a three-pointer, and the Heat take a four-point lead.
To Marion. Blocked by Wade. What a defensive play from Dwayne Wade.
They've got Wade and LeBron, and Dallas doesn't.
The Mavs fought hard, but Miami close.
1-0 in the best of seven for Miami.
We'll make our adjustments, baby, and look that we missed some opportunities tonight. But hey, that's why they call it the finals.
We've been good on the road all season long. We in the playoffs, we had some big wins on the road. So we kind of felt confident that, hey, we can steal one down there.
We've done a lot of talking about it the last couple days. And I think we know where it's at. Play to exhaustion. That's the biggest thing.
Knocked away by Nowitzki. It's picked up by Terry. Racing with Wade. Got to the rim and laid it up and in.
You can tell they've come out much better prepared.
Wade to the basket with a dunk.
James veering to his right on the drive. Got the lane to the rim and threw it down.
Here's Wade on the fast break. Behind the back around Nowitzki. Oh. Reverse dunk. What a play by Wade.
And the Heat have blown this game open. Their largest lead of the night, 15. Dallas has been the team that has owned the fourth quarter. We've seen it from the Mavericks all season. Never giving up. Back up to Kidd. Wide open for three. Knocks it down.
They will never quit on the game. And they're hanging in again tonight.
Terry the drive. Terry the pull-up. It's good. A terrific run here. And this crowd is stunned.
That whole run against Miami was just tremendous. Being down 0-1, fighting back in game two, down 10 with about 4 minutes left.
To the top of the arc and down to Dirk. He's open for three on the way. It's good! It's good! A 20-2 run. One of the most incredible comebacks in NBA Finals history.
Nowitzki gets the ball outside the three-point line. Works it on Bach.
Spin inside. Nowitzki, the easy layup and in. Dallas shocks Miami and wins at 95-93.
Big win for us, man. It's a game we had to have. Going back home now, we're going to get a warm welcome. Our fans are going to be ready.
Run out on by Wade. Put it on the floor at the foul line, and then Wade blocked his shot and comes out of there with the ball.
He is lighting it up here in the first half.
Crowd trying to urge the Maverick to make another comeback. Nowitzki wide open for three. That's good. Much-needed three-pointer for the Mavericks. Tough physical battle between the two best teams. They get it to Kidd, left of the circle. Backdoor cut, finds Dirk, dunks it as he beat Boston to tie the game at 84. And another fabulous fourth quarter comeback for the Mavericks.
Who will take a 2-1 advantage in these finals?
Bosch on the wing, the jumper got it on the wing. And he nails it when he needed it most.
Now lobs it to Dirk against Haslam on the move. Spins left, steps back from 18. Hits the heel of the rim. It bounces away. And Miami has won the game and has taken a 2-1 lead in the NBA Finals.
It was a big game and a very tough loss. But they need two more, so basically a must-win situation.
Our mental approach in this game is going to be a Game 7 mentality, and we're looking forward to it.
Go Mavericks!
Dirk looks exhausted tonight.
We've confirmed that Dirk Nowitzki is playing tonight's basketball game with a fever perhaps as high as 100 degrees.
Nowitzki has been brilliant here in the finals, but he desperately needs some help.
Slices through the defense, and he puts it in! Wild shot by Barea. Marion's got to make something happen. Drive across the lane. Shot, he banks it in. LeBron, the alley-oop. Wade, two-hand jam! Shot clock at two. Bosh knocked away.
Ahead for Terry on the run out. Lays it up and in. And the Mavericks have the lead at 79-78. And Jets got the wings out.
This crowd's so anxious right now. They're Mavericks down 2-1. And there it is in the hands of Nowitzki, who's got about 102 fever. Haslam right up on him.
Driving right and lays it in. Oh! The game is over. And this series is tied at two games apiece.
It was a sweet victory for us, man. Something we had to do. Do or die.
It was just under the weather a little bit, but this is the finals. I mean, you got to go out there and compete.
Game 5 has given us some of the biggest moments in NBA Finals history. What will unfold tonight?
Here's Kidd. A steal off a Bibby pass. On the way. Lays it in with the left hand at the left of the rim.
picked up by Marion. He drives on James, spins on him in the lane.
And the Mavs with this tempo have already taken control of this game.
The Heat have not lost back-to-back games in these playoffs.
And James throws it down. Chalmers gets it off in time. Oh, he puts it in! Mario Chalmers at the buzzer. Miami is going to take the lead. Kidd, straight away three, good!
Nowitzki, high arcing three.
Oh! A rainbow goes through!
What a shooting clinic! Stripped. Excellent double team. Mike Miller with the help. Off the turnover, James to Wade. Banks it in. Looks like we're going right down to the wire for the fourth straight game.
This is one of the best final games I have ever seen.
Nowitzki, quick move and the finish!
In 2006, in the NBA Finals, I missed a three. It tied the game and sent us to overtime.
Way off the mark.
In game five, in 2011, in the same spot, I took the same shot.
Terry, a long three. Bang! Jason Terry!
And I hit it over LeBron, and then I flew off down the court, and that sealed victory in game five.
And the Mavericks are one win away from an NBA championship.
What a performance from the veteran Dallas Mavericks.
You can't even understate what it means for us to go out here in game six and to finish the job. You can't. It's big, historic.
We approach game six as game seven. You don't want to give this team life. You don't want to give a great team like that hope, and especially in front of their home fans.
Everybody wears all black. That's our ritual and close our games. Got to get it done.
We knew they were going to hit us with a couple punches early.
To James with six on the clock. Takes a three. And hit.
LeBron made a couple of shots. They were up early.
The perfect start for Miami.
We did a good job in that game, kind of always sticking around. I couldn't make a shot to save my life, but the team was great. Jet was amazing again. JJ got to the paint and made some great plays.
Chandler throws it down.
On the wing, House for three.
Got it! And Miami leads by two.
We took those punches, and that really sent a good message to our players. Hey, we're in this, we're here to stay, even though our best player is struggling, and we're still right here.
What a playoffs this young man has had.
You look at the body language, and it looks like a heavyweight champ that realizes he's held on too long. He's in trouble.
Boy, as Terry took some huge shots, especially down the stretch of the two wins in games four and five.
I think at that particular time, we had been together 7 years. It's like it meant so much what I went through with my teammates in 2006.
Jet mentioned it to me, I think it was in the fourth quarter, and it was still kind of close games. Like, just keep pushing, man, keep pushing. Remember 06, we're not going to let this happen again. I think it was constantly on his mind and on my mind here and there.
Nowitzki puts it up. Puts it in. Dirk Nowitzki makes it a 10-point game. The Mavericks celebrating on the bench.
We're kind of walking at half court, and there's just a picture of Dirk kind of grabbing me, you know, like a little son. And he just put his arms around me, like put my head on his chest and just was like, man, we did it.
The Dallas Mavericks are NBA champions. The first title in franchise history. The emotions of Dirk Nowitzki, what he's always dreamed of, hoping to have another chance after the bitter loss in 2006.
Just an amazing feeling afterwards.
There's no other feeling better than winning a championship. It's awesome. Like, I don't know if I can say it in any words.
I seen Cuban. He just ran up on me and just bear hugged me.
Come here, Jet! Come here!
And was like, I love you, Jet.
For the first time in franchise history, the Dallas Mavericks have won the NBA championship. And the MVP of this series, Dirk Nowitzki.
The biggest moment for me was seeing my mother and my father on the stage embracing for a young man to be able to accomplish something in front of his parents that were not together growing up. It just was a great moment in my life.
Nobody can ever take this away from us. We're the best team that was out there. That feels amazing.
This is sweet joy, sweet vindication. And I'll never forget this day.
It took me 12 years to get this. I'm not letting it go.
For us to get revenge of what happened in 06, we made that bad memory go away.